Sound of the 60s. And the catchy song that I tried to sing, I tried to say earlier on, I now have it confirmed, I got it right. Do wa diddy diddy dum diddy do.
Yeah, but did you get it right? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think I did. Come on, gentlemen, help us out here. We've got Paul Jones and Tom McGuiness here from the Manfreds. Did I get it right?
I got hold of a copy of the original sheet music. See, we didn't do that song first. It was a group called The Exciters. Yep. And when I got hold of that sheet music, it actually says, do wa diddy, diddy down, diddy do.
Shall we listen to you making that not very obvious mistake then? Here it is.
She was just walking down the street singing.
Paul, we're loving the knee work there. Yeah. The knee, movement across.
What can you remember doing that? Can you remember thinking, right, at this point, I'm going to move the maracas and I'm going to wiggle my knee?
No, I don't remember wiggling my knees, but I do remember playing the maracas because I still play them.
Ah.
The funny is, looking back at that now, and the sort of the drainpipe trousers, there could be probably a band now who's trying to look like that. It's funny how time comes round, things come round, don't they?
Oh, yeah. We did a gig last night in Stafford, and there were a young couple there who looked as though they'd stepped out of 1964. The clothes, the hair, the dresses.
It was a stylish time, though, wasn't it? Do you look back at that and think, actually, do you know what, we look OK?
No. Do you want a fuller answer, or will that do?
I just laugh. You know, I think, oh, what was I thinking wearing that?
And can we just decide the do or diddy thing, before we leave that, put that to one side, does it mean anything? Is there a meaning?
Well, we actually met one of the writers. It was written by a husband and wife team, Jeff Barry and Ellie Greenwich. They were still together at the time. And Jeff came to see us in our hotel in New York, and this would be the winter of 1964-5. And he was lovely. And he'd sort of dressed as what he thought was an English gentleman. He had the tightly furled umbrella and striped trousers. Oh, really? And things like that, and a briefcase. We had a nice chat, and I said, before you go, Jeff, what does it actually mean, do what diddy, diddy, dum, diddy, do? He said, I'll tell you what it means. It means I never need to work again.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
That's classic, isn't it?
It's a good answer.
You mentioned you're on tour, aren't you?
Yeah, Paul and I have a couple of bands, the Manfreds and the Blues Band, and we do 120 gigs a year.
That's a lot.
Yeah, well, people say that. It doesn't seem like that when you're doing it. It's such fun playing music live, working together, having an audience turn up. You know, that is really why I got into it in the first place. I'd be playing in a pub if I hadn't been successful. I just like that interplay with an audience.
And I dare say, as we saw, you know, that footage, that would have been around, 63?
That's 64.
64. I mean, I don't know what you were thinking at that time, maybe just enjoying the moment, but could you possibly imagine that, you know, all this time later?
Do you know, I never thought that we would have that moment of stardom and then become obscure. I always knew that it was a lifetime job, and it is.
I didn't know that. I can remember doing a ballroom in about 1965, and there were about 800 people there. And I said to the manager, oh, not as many as last time. There were 1,200 or so last time. He said, well, you haven't had a hit for 3 months. Yes. And I thought, wow, it's that short term.
Wow. But it was such a golden era, wasn't it? What were those days like?
In a way, I think it became more golden when it stopped being singles and started to be albums. Because then there was a kind of permanence, you know, which didn't exist before that. You really were as big as your current hit. And if you hadn't got a current hit, you weren't very big.
Yeah, and you mentioned the audiences that come now. You get all sorts of different generations turning up.
Occasionally you get three generations there, which is lovely. Or quite often two generations. But we were in Tokyo a couple of years back. And it was very different there. The audience were predominantly 20 and 30-year-olds, and they were wearing the 60s clothes.
Well, I suppose the upside of that particular single, Do or Diddy, is no language barrier there.
Yeah. That's absolutely right. You could walk down the street in Peru and say, there she was just walking down the street and bang, would
they're
come
in with the chorus.
And you still play it, I imagine? You close with it?
We cornered the market in those simple ones. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Hubble Bubble, wow. Shalala, Do or Diddy. Yeah. International language.
Lovely to see you at this point. Thank you so much.
I'm off to go write a song, I think.
Yeah.
Let's
keep
try
it simple.
Try if we can.
A new album's Manfred Mann, The Greatest Hits and More.
We'll be back tomorrow from 6 o'clock on BBC One.
Yes, Nag and I will be here tomorrow.
You've got
David Baddiel will be here as well. Thank you, gentlemen, very much. And it's
pleasure.
Goodbye from
us.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Sorry.